Did you know that it's been possible to set up your Apple AirPods Pro as hearing aids since the tail end of 2020? Apple have recently enhanced this feature further still with a bunch of new features for those with hearing loss. In this video, I'll round up all of those features and show you exactly how to set up your AirPods Pro as hearing aids. Hey guys, it's Matthew here from Hearing Tracker, keeping you up to date with all things hearing related. If you are interested in keeping up to date with the latest news in the hearing technology world, then make sure that you subscribe to this channel, hit that grey notifications bell, and you'll be updated every time we release a new video. So today's video is something that I'm super excited to share with you guys, as for me, the changes that we're seeing with the hearing technology at the moment are all about making things more accessible to those with hearing loss and encouraging more and more people to investigate and manage their hearing health. If you've seen any of my other recent videos reviewing over-the-counter devices, such as the Jabra Enhanced Pluses or the Olive Union Pros, you'll know that I'm really keen on getting hearing aid technology in as many people's ears as possible. Dare I say it, even if it's outside of the traditional route of having hearing aids fitted by an audiologist. Whilst I would still recommend seeing an audiologist, cost is sometimes a barrier, as hearing aids can cost anything upwards of $1,800 and are often not covered by insurance companies, which will always baffle me. So recognizing this over the last couple of years, Apple have been gradually developing and adding features to both their operating system and AirPods for those with hearing loss. In what is without question already a crowded market, they've introduced some pretty smart technology to ensure that they stand out, and therefore there is so much tech crammed into the AirPods Pro, which means that if you're an Apple user and you've got a set of AirPods Pro already, then you may already have the gear that you need to be able to enhance your hearing. So on my iPhone, I'm currently running iOS version 15.4.1, which is laden with features to help those with a mild to moderate hearing loss. Apple have a great section on their website covering all of their accessibility features for those with a hearing impairment, which I'll link in the description to today's video. But stay where you are, as I'm going to run through each of those relevant features for AirPods being used as hearing aids right now. To access these features on your iPhone, head over to the Settings, Accessibility, and then the Audio Visual section. Here you can find their great hearing-related features, such as background sounds to help if you suffer with tinnitus, mono audio, which is useful if you only have hearing in one ear, and then sound balance, which enables you to balance the level of volume between your ears. The one that I'm most keen on showing you now is the headphone accommodations right at the top. Since iOS 14, we've had the ability to add an audiogram to your iPhone, believe it or not. Apple don't allow you to test your hearing directly through their features. However, you can upload your hearing test results in a few different ways. First of all, using the camera, you can take a photograph and it will pull the information across. Plus, it does the same with a photo if you upload that. This assumes that you've already had your hearing tested, however, by an audiologist. Alternatively, there are a few apps out there that you can use to test your hearing using your AirPods Pro, such as the Mimi Hearing Test, which will pull your audiogram through to the Help section of your iPhone, and I'll link the app to the description in today's video. The app itself is free, and in total, the testing process took me around 5 minutes to do both ears. The Mimi app presents you with pulse tones of various frequencies, firstly with the left ear, followed by the right, increase and decreasing the sound until you can no longer hear it. The app starts with mid-tones and then increases to test the highs and then down to the lows, testing 6 different frequencies in total. The test sounds themselves were nice and pure, which is a good start, as with other tech that I've reviewed in the past, I've heard a clicking sound or a distortion which has hindered the accuracy of the results. Of course, the testing isn't as comprehensive as going to an audiology clinic and having your ears examined and having a full audiogram performed using both air conduction and bone conduction. However, it's a start, and in an ideal world before being tested, you would really want someone to at least have examined your ears to ensure that you don't have anything else going on, such as an ear infection or something as simple as a buildup of wax, which may be causing your hearing to be reduced. On a side note, I do love that the app activates the microphone on your phone whilst you're testing, so if the environmental noise around you becomes too loud, it pauses the test to ensure that your results are accurate. And when you're done, at the end of the testing process, it displays your results. In all honesty, I wasn't entirely happy with the accuracy of them. So first of all, here are a copy of my hearing test results with medical grade audiological equipment. And as you can see, I've got normal hearing across all frequencies, which is anything above 20 decibels. To compare, here are the test results that I did using the Mimi app. And as you can see, based on standard audiological data, it's assessed me as having a mild hearing loss in the low frequencies, which is anything between 20 to 40 decibels. To be honest, this isn't really a surprise, as with these kind of headphones, any small gaps around where the headphones are sitting will allow some of those low frequencies to escape, and therefore the sound won't be being picked up by my eardrums. Fortunately, I know this as an audiologist, so it doesn't necessarily concern me too much or make me think or worried that my hearing is going down in the lower frequencies. However, for a non-audiologist to see this, my only concern is that they'll worry that they have a hearing loss, which isn't necessarily true. My other concern is that when this hearing test is then imported to the health section of my phone now thinks that I have a 21 decibels average hearing threshold in the left ear and 24 decibels in the right. So when we pull it through to the headphone accommodations, the sound reproduction will be giving me more emphasis in the low frequencies than I actually need to compensate for my hearing loss. Now you may be thinking, so what? I'll just get a little bit more low frequency amplification. However, the downside is that background noise tends to be made up of low frequencies, such as the general hubbub in a restaurant or car noise when you're traveling. So by adding extra amplification in the lower frequencies, you're actually adding more of the sounds that you really don't want to be hearing, which will potentially result in overwhelming the clarity of the speech that you do want to be hearing. So as you can see here, once it's imported into the health section of your iPhone, it then appears neatly in the headphone accommodation, which will automatically enhance the sound reproduction accordingly. If you have a nearly symmetrical audiogram, the headphone accommodations will take the average of the two ears and fit the left and the right audio channels with that specific profile. If, however, you have an asymmetrical audiogram, it will fit the left and the right audio channels towards your better ear. One thing to note is that the AirPods Pro are only suitable for those with a mild to moderate hearing loss. So if your hearing loss falls below 70 decibels on a hearing test, then they won't be powerful enough to manage your hearing loss. Okay, so now that we've imported the hearing test results, what does that mean? It means that with any sounds being streamed from your phone to your AirPods Pro, such as phone calls, music, the radio, or podcasts, your phone should add the appropriate amount of sound at that particular frequency that's necessary to compensate for your hearing loss, which is pretty cool. And I must say, it makes a big difference. The AirPods Pro have a few different modes to choose from when you're wearing them. Of particular importance is the active noise cancellation, which uses the outward-facing microphones of the AirPods Pro to detect external sound, which your AirPods then counter with anti-noise. This actually cancels the external sounds before you're able to hear them. And then afterwards, there's also an inward-facing microphone, which listens inside your ear for unwanted internal sounds, which again are then cancelled, resulting in you hearing very limited sounds from the environment around you. Secondly, we also have the transparency mode, which does the complete opposite and allows environmental sounds in so that you can hear exactly what's going on around you. And to be honest, it's kind of trippy when you first start hearing it, as your brain is telling you that your ears are blocked. However, you can still hear everything that's going on around you. As we head into the transparency mode customizable setup, you can see that you can personalize this further still to your hearing needs by increasing the amplification or the volume of the sound coming through, adjusting the left or right balance, putting a greater amount of emphasis on the bass or treble of whoever speaking in front of you whilst you've got the AirPods in, with the bass contributing to the fullness and richness of their voice, and the treble the clarity and detail. And then finally, you can adjust the ambient noise reduction, which allows you to adjust the amount of background noise that the AirPods Pro will be picking up from the environment around you. Tucked away at the bottom of this menu, which I really think should be at the top, is the Conversation Boost feature, which is the very latest addition to the hearing features. Initially introduced in iOS 15, Apple boasts that this focuses your AirPods Pro on the person in front of you using computational audio and directional beamforming, which are features that we've traditionally seen in hearing aids, that provides forwards-facing directionality with an ultra-narrow beam, isolating sounds coming in front of you so that you can hear clearly in noisy environments. There has been some really interesting objective studies published evaluating the effectiveness of the AirPods Pro for enhancing conversations and how they actually cope in background noise. These have been done independently of Apple as well, which are the kind of studies that really interest me. The most recent study published in March of this year, titled Evaluation of Apple AirPods Pro with Conversation Boost and Ambient Noise Reduction for People with Hearing Loss in Noisy Environments, which I will link in the description to this video. In summary, their results showed that both the conversational boost and ambient noise reduction features of AirPods Pro showed an improvement for hearing in background noise of around 7 decibels for a speaker located in front of a listener in a noisy environment, resulting in an increase in speech intelligibility compared to where no hearing devices were worn at all. So, it looks like Apple are definitely heading in the right direction. Now, I've spoken about some of the awesome features that the AirPods Pro have, but there are also a few considerations that you need to take into account when thinking about using them as hearing aids. First of all, battery life. The batteries on your AirPods Pro will normally only last for around 4.5 hours. However, with all of these other features enabled, such as transparency mode and the conversational boost, I'm sure that this will come down further still, and Apple have yet to release any further data on this. Ideally, with any hearing aid, you don't want to start wearing them at 8 in the morning and then for them to be dead by lunch. The batteries inside AirPods Pro are also not replaceable, so after a couple of years of intense daily use, your battery life is going to be shortened further still. While traditional hearing aids are known to be far more efficient in this area, and a 3-hour charge, which is normally done overnight, should allow for 24 hours of use based on that full charge. Another challenge with managing hearing loss with headphones is something called the occlusion effect. Typically, with an age-related hearing loss, the user would have good hearing in the low tones and want to keep the ear canals as open as possible for a more natural way of listening. With the AirPods Pro blocking your ears, my worry is that it will feel a bit like you've got your fingers stuck in your ears all the time and may not be the most comfortable for when you're speaking or eating. With the actual effect being that you'll be able to really feel your own voice booming and trapped inside your head. This will potentially limit those that will benefit from wearing the AirPods Pros as hearing aids. Saying that, the transparency mode really does help with this, and for the first time with any similar tech that I've recently reviewed, the occlusion effect is definitely minimized when the transparency mode is enabled. To counter that, there are also a couple of benefits of occluding your ears more. First of all, if the ears are completely occluded, then it can result in better hearing and background noise, as all of the sound that reaches your eardrum is being channeled through the hearing device, which can then clean up the signal. Whereas with a loosely fitting tip, there may be sound creeping through which hasn't been cleaned up and therefore could potentially make it more challenging to hear in a noisy environment. The second benefit of more occluded ear canals comes down to the sound reproduction when streaming. As the tighter the fitting, the better bass response you'll get, so the sound in theory should have more of a fullness, richness, and depth to it. So you know what? In summary, I think that these are a great tool and going forward will definitely have their place for managing hearing loss. I do think that they should be fitted with caution as the hearing assessment process is not yet as accurate as I think it should be. I would suggest that the best application would be to have a comprehensive hearing assessment with an audiologist and then use that audiogram for the fitting process. I'm also still not entirely sure that the world is ready for people to be wandering around wearing their headphones all the time. And if I were to sit down at dinner wearing a set of headphones, would people think that I was being rude or listening to music whilst I was wearing them? I don't know, maybe it's in my head. Perhaps not if they knew I was wearing them as hearing aids. But then that means I would need the confidence to say I was using them as hearing aids, and not a lot of people are happy to admit it. That's the whole purpose behind this. Saying that, this new concept of wearing headphones as hearing aids needs to start somewhere, and I feel that we're on the cusp of this becoming the norm. Whilst I don't yet feel that AirPods Pro are going to be as effective as a set of traditional hearing aids for all of the reasons that I've outlined today, I'm really excited that Apple are making waves in the hearing technology world. And I would recommend to anyone to put something in their ears rather than nothing whatsoever. So if you're not ready for a traditional hearing aid due to cosmetics or the cost, then there's no harm in trying them out, as we're talking about the cost of $250 versus thousands of dollars to see an audiologist. And I personally imagine them as being a stepping stone in the right direction to getting traditional hearing aids. Let me know what you think in the comments to this video. Do you think you'd be happy to wear them all day, or would you prefer them to be a little bit more discreet? I hope that you found this video helpful, guys. If you like this video, then please hit like. If you have any questions, then drop them in the comments below, and I'll be sure to get back to you as soon as possible. Plus, if you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you do so. I'll see you in the next video.